Hi, so today I want to talk about the Sioux hypothesis. And the Sioux hypothesis is a hypothesis that hypothesizes that we as the human civilization, that somehow we have aliens, an advanced alien civilization that is watching us. And that can be for several reasons. One of them could be that they are watching us to see like an experiment. In a similar way, how we could live in a simulation and the creators of the simulation could be watching us and seeing how everything unfolded. Perfect way to understand your past better is just to simulate it. If determinism is true, which it is, but quantum physics makes it a bit complicated, but if you knew the position of every single particle and particle of light, the photon, and the position of every single proton and neutron at 1 second after the Big Bang, if you had the information, you could just run the simulation and you could see everything that you missed out on. You could see everything unfold. But it's not absolutely certain how doable is that. Certainly with advanced artificial intelligence, it would be something that could easily figure out, even if you don't have any access to that information of the initial conditions of our universe exactly. We have good approximations and we have, I believe, more than enough information to produce an accurate simulation so we could see how our past really happens. And that's a fascinating other topic. So one thing would be that they might look at us just as a sort of observation. Now, one thing to be clear, how I feel, it is one of those interesting thoughts, and it's, in my mind, it's one of those things that's just exciting to think about. And I don't believe that's the case. I believe that might be the case in like passing by accident. But again, the central point of it is basically, long story short, is that human beings are so special. And if we move away from believing in God or higher powers like that, then we replace it with something else. Might as well be aliens that are still looking after us and they care about us. And if something goes really, really wrong, then maybe they will rescue us. But until then, they are waiting until we are advanced enough as a civilization. And then they will accept us into this galactic, you know, community of different civilizations. So it sounds, in a certain point of view, it sounds appealing that, you know, it's wonderful that we are not alone, that there are some more intelligent species who know actually what's going on in the universe, who might be observing us. So we are not alone and one day we might meet them. But I think the bit more terrifying possibility is that we are alone and we are not that special. Nature and the universe is chaotic and unfair, and we as human beings have so many different approaches and interpretations of things that we want to believe just because we like to believe them and just because they make us feel good. But if you want to think accurately about the world, then we have to be intellectually honest with ourselves and go through everything we believe one by one, and to make sure that we don't believe in stuff just because we want to believe in it. You can believe whatever you want, but I'm talking about specifically if you want to have some confidence in understanding the world, if you want to be as accurate as you can, then that is the case. That don't just believe anything, you know, think critically about it. So one thing I think definitely a part of it, even if a lot of people who believe in this Sioux hypothesis, I definitely believe one part of it is that it's this innate human tendency to feel that we are the center of the universe, that we are special. So that is one thing, but definitely isn't impossible. I think it's absolutely possible that some super advanced alien civilization is like quietly colonizing the galaxy, and they just happened upon our planet, and they known about us for like thousands of years, or maybe longer, maybe millions of years, watching how life on Earth develops. Then I think it's an interesting ethical question, and this is something that we have talked about before, and that is the idea of what is the ethical or moral responsibility of a super highly advanced species? What is their responsibility? You know, do they come to a point of understanding that nature is just nature, it's none of their business, let life go on as it goes on, you know, they just seeing what happens? Or do they feel a sense of responsibility, a kind of obligation that they are conscious, and we developing here, we are conscious, and that consciousness is a precious thing, And suffering is a real experience, and it's not a nice experience for any being who experiences it. So it would be best to eliminate suffering. If those aliens really believed that, and if they really cared about us, then they could easily come here and solve our problems now. And I don't believe that there's some kind of trick to it, or some kind of, you know, some kind of thought in that, that they're just waiting, like, will they figure it out or will they not figure it out? Like, either they want us to succeed and they will come to help us, or they absolutely don't care at all. Like, I don't believe that way of thinking, that they're just quietly waiting or we'll see if they figure it out. Like, what kind of a stupid game would it be to just let us kill ourselves and be stupid if they could step in and help us? It's like you having a child and seeing the child like hurt themselves and do stupid stuff, but you're just, you know, far away watching and seeing, oh, we'll see how it plays out, you know, maybe the kid will, you know, somehow survive, maybe he won't, you know. Either way, like, I'm fine just looking at it. Like, you help your kid or you don't help your kid. What a weird way of thinking would it be? Let's see how it plays out. Ultimately, of course, at the end of the day, nothing is real. Life is just a game, you know? Like, none of it matters. But if there is something to value in the universe, then I think that is consciousness. Now, whether or not consciousness would be so easy to create and so common that it's basically pennies, it's worth nothing, that, you know, we might have our pocket of human civilization, but it's like worth nothing in the grand scale, the scheme of the entire universe, you know, that might be possible, that we are not actually at the center of the universe. I have said before that I think that the more advanced civilization gets, the less aggressive they become, because there's less need for aggression. And we can really easily see it with the advancement of human beings as well. The smarter we get, and in individuals as well, not always, but it tends to be that the smarter you are, the more experience you gain, the more understanding and empathy you have towards other people. So I think that's a tendency with civilizations as well. Because any civilization who would just be aggressive, you know, simply would not survive. So the ones who kind of find peace in just being conscious creatures, you know, they would survive. So the zoo hypothesis is to me, like, that's how I feel about it. I think it's one of these human-centric ideas. You know, one part of it is this human-centric idea that we are being watched, we are so special, you know, we are the center of the universe, all of the aliens' attention is on us, we are so important, and whatever happens here, you know, and they're waiting and cheering for us quietly that we'll figure it out. Like, I think that is silly. But I think there might be some super advanced alien civilizations that have like probes, that have super advanced artificial intelligence and like nanorobotics, whatever, just flying through the solar system and being keeping some sort of eye on us, you know, in passing, you know. So I think that is possible. The Fermi paradox as well is an interesting topic to think about, because we don't see any advanced alien life. Like, with pretty much all philosophical issues, I'm of two minds, because I think it's important to appreciate both of the viewpoints. A lot of things really are, they're just good sides, good arguments for both sides. So one would be that we look around the universe, we don't see any signs of advanced civilizations. We don't see mega structures around stars. We don't see huge colonizing ships, you know. It doesn't take long to colonize a galaxy and make it super advanced, just teeming with life and intelligence and, you know, good experiences for all. But I think that might be misguided. That might be, again, the simple human primate, you know, tendency of us to think that the main goal always is just to advance and to expand and to colonize and all this stuff. Maybe if we advanced far enough, you know, that seems silly to us. You know, like, what's the point? If we can create like super realistic simulations that are really immersive, and you can feel you are connected to entire humanity and more, and you can feel any experience you want, like literally any experience you want, you can have the experience of colonizing the universe, you know, with very little effort. Why do you go out there when you have super intelligence that you can work together to solve all the deepest questions of the universe? So I don't think the priority would be to colonize everything and stuff like that, but I do think it would be a bit odd to make like no backups at all and to not go at all. So if I don't think it would be like full on colonization, like as fast as we can, just build stuff everywhere. But I think it would be some obvious moves towards some more expansion, but not like crazy much. So one way of looking at it would be that we really don't see signs of intelligent life, and no radio signals either. But like that's again radio signals, just human way of thinking. That's where our technology is right now, so we expect an answer from there. And the universe is huge, and the universe is really old, and the chance of us looking in any particular direction and us hearing, even if some alien civilization sent the message, we have to listen at the exact right time that it took for the electromagnetic waves to travel to us. A billion years ago, they might send a message to us for like 5 minutes, and we have to listen that exact 5 minutes, billion years after they sent it. We have to be ready. So the chances of that are like astronomical. They're like lottery. The same way that we have sent radio messages, we see some interesting galaxy cluster and we sent the message to it. Guess how long we sent the message to them? Like a few minutes. And we expect that during millions of years that civilization is going to change so much, we expect them to be right there at the right time in the right direction, looking and listening to 5 minutes that we have sent the message to them. And then we're like, oh, well, I don't think they respond. They don't exist. That is stupid. If you get where I'm going with this. But the other side to this, detecting no advanced civilizations, would be that life, biological life, hundreds of billions of galaxies, hundreds of billions of stars, incomprehensible amount of possibilities. I would be dead surprised if among those billions there wouldn't be at least thousands of planets with some form of life on them. That would be just crazy. It already is crazy reality, like, So Sue hypothesis is one thing. I think it's also one of the sort of things that we want. We want there to be some kind of a daddy that when we finally figure things out, that then they would be, come down to earth and give us a hug and tell us that it's all right and you did well, But again, I think that's a childish way of thinking. The future is crazy, and we will figure this stuff out. We will get answers to the Fermi paradox as well, because we can be really smart. So these are just some of my thoughts about the zoo hypothesis. I hope there was something interesting here for you. If you have any thoughts, please share them in the comments. And of course, thank you so much for watching, and take care.